Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2399. Get a unique count of just the visible cells after applying a filter. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. A great question today from Vivek. This was an old video, 1034, that does count the visible rows. And Vivek wants to say he wants to count the unique values in a similar fashion. So apply a filter using the filter dropdowns and then count just the unique values. All right, so here's my solution to this. And it requires Microsoft 365 or Excel 2021 because I'm going to use the new unique and filter function. I'm going to first add a helper column out here that is called visible. And it's going to be equal subtotal. Number three, that's the count A of just this one cell over here, A2. And that returns a one to say that that row is visible, like that. And of course, if I would just sum that, it would, in this case, give me 20, right? Because there's 20 rows. But the beautiful thing is, this is like, does the light in the refrigerator go out when you close the door? If I would apply a filter here to just the apple cells, see, that number changes, which means that all of the hidden rows are changing to zero as well. All right, so our solution to get a unique list of the names over in column A is we're going to do the count A of the unique of the filter. And we're going to filter all the names in column A. Which names do we want? We want the ones that are visible, and that will be column D. Column D is either going to return 1 or 0. 1s are going to be considered true, and we get it. Zeros are false, and we don't. So 1, 2, 3 closing parentheses. And right now we have 10 unique names. If we would choose just banana, and we have 5 names: Barb, Diane, Flo, Hank, Jared, Jared. The second Jared isn't counted, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Choosing something else: Apple, Andy, Chris, Ed, Gary, Ike. Throw out Andy and Jared, and we get 6. Right, so it works. That little helper function right there. Now, again, unique and filter are new in 2019. It came out after Excel 2019 came out, so you need either Microsoft 365 or the new Excel 2021, or of course later than that. Dynamic arrays are discussed in this book, Excel Dynamic Arrays, straight to the point. Click that I in the top right hand corner. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank Vivek for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.